Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing good. So today we are going to study about the salivary glands and their functions and types. So if you see, salivary glands are a pair of glands that are situated in the cheek region, or you can say in the side of your face, and they are usually the main function of these salivary glands is to secrete saliva in your mouth, right? The function of saliva is that it is going to keep your oral cavity moist, so it will keep the oral cavity moist. At the same time, it will also keep the oral cavity clean. Moving ahead to the classification of salivary glands, we can classify salivary glands on the basis of their size, or secondly, we can classify them on the basis of nature of their secretion. Moving ahead to the first classification, that is on the basis of size, we have the major salivary glands and then we have some minor salivary glands. The major ones are the ones we have to focus more on. So in the major one, we have the parotid gland that is situated near your ear region. Then you have the submandibular gland and the sublingual salivary gland. The location of all these salivary glands would be shown in the picture I'm showing you further. Then further, we have the minor salivary glands. In the minor salivary glands, we have the glossopalatine, the palatine, labial and buccal glands, postlingual glands, and the von Ebner's gland. So these are some of the major as well as some of the minor salivary glands that we have. Okay. Moving ahead to on the basis of nature of secretion. So usually we have serous, mucus, and mix. This is the three type we have on the basis of the secretion they do. Now on serous, we have the parotid glands and the von Ebner gland. Keeping in mind that von Ebner is basically a minor salivary gland, still it is considered to be a part of serous salivary gland. Now mucus, in that we have all minor salivary glands except the von Ebner gland that is added in the serous one, and the mixed we have the submandibular and the sublingual salivary gland. Moving ahead to their location, so you'd see the most prominent one, or you can say the largest salivary gland, is your parotid salivary gland that is situated in the cheek region near the ear. Then you have the sublingual that is situated somewhere here. And then you have the submandibular salivary gland that is near this portion of the face, okay? These are the location of the three type of major salivary glands that we have. Then we also have some minor salivary glands, but then their location is not that important. And if you see in this vertical view or side view, then this is the parotid gland, the largest one. And most of the time the tumors happen in this only. And then we have this, the submandibular and the sublingual salivary gland. Moving ahead, what are the functions of saliva? So to learn the functions of saliva, I have this mnemonic here for you all. So the mnemonic here says, my doctor table always set. So the doctor table is always set. This is what you have to keep in mind. So from my, you take this M, D, T, A, and S, E, T. So this is the M, D, T, A, S, E, T, right? So from my, you can make the word mechanical. From doctor, you can make digestive. Table, taste perception. From always, we have antimicrobial. And from the set, we have this speech, excretion, and the tissue repair. Now, we'd be seeing the function of each following them. Firstly, you have to remember all the major points from this mnemonic. And then what is their function is described further. If you see the mechanical action, then what is going to happen? Basically, saliva is going to keep your oral tissue and oral cavity moist. It will facilitate swallowing. Also, it will provide cleansing and the buffering action, which will prevent your mouth or teeth from the dental caries. So what happens is, you know that we have studied this in dental caries also, saliva basically acts as a natural defensive of the oral cavity, natural defense mechanism. A patient who's having more saliva in his mouth, he's going to have less chances of caries, because saliva, it is doing a role, that is, it is playing a very important role, that is, it is cleaning the oral cavity regularly. The action of saliva inside the oral cavity cleans the oral cavity, due to which chances of dental caries decrease a lot. Then also, saliva controls the calcium and phosphate concentration around the teeth. So these are some of the mechanical action. Then we see to the digestive action. In the digestive action, you see by providing fluid environment for the solubilization of the food. So I just told you that basically your saliva will keep the oral cavity moist, and when the oral cavity is moist, the food will very easily flow down into the esophagus. Then saliva has amylase, which helps in digestion of carbohydrates to produce glucose. So basically it helps in breaking of carbohydrates to produce glucose, because it contains amylase. The saliva contains amylase. Then the next thing we have is taste perception. Due to the presence of water in saliva, it dissolves the food and helps in better taste perception. Talking about speech, it keeps the oral tissue moist, due to which speech is facilitated. Moving ahead to tissue repair, very important point. Now, how does it help in tissue repair? Basically, due to a presence of variety of growth factor in the saliva, it promotes tissue growth and this is a different point, tissue growth, differentiation and wound healing. So, because our saliva is containing a lot of factors which helps in growth, that is the reason that there is increased growth, increased chances of differentiation that helps in proper and early wound healing. That is the major reason why saliva is a major factor or it has a major feature of tissue repair also. Now, what is the role in excretion? Many substances from the blood reaches the saliva, hence it also comes in considered to be a route of excretion. Okay, so because all the toxins from our body which is to be excreted out of the body, sometimes they reach into the saliva also, and by the route of saliva we excrete it out from our body, and that is the reason it is also playing an important role in excretion. The last action we have is the antimicrobial action. Now, how is it antimicrobial in action, saliva? Basically, the lysosome in the saliva, it has got an antibacterial action. So, you just remember this lysosome which is present in the saliva is antibacterial in action. Also, saliva has got some important immunoglobulins like IgA, IgM and IgG which helps and acts as a defensive substance in the saliva, okay? Also, there is presence of peroxidase which acts as a bactericidal effect, which provides bactericidal effect due to which the unwanted or the foreign bodies that can affect us are being killed by the saliva only. Okay, so these were all the actions about saliva, the types of salivary glands, what all role is the saliva and salivary glands producing. I hope that the video was simple and easy to you to understand. If you like the video, please share and subscribe. Also, let me know your reviews in the comment section. Thank you.